Hello students, welcome back to my channel. So in the last class we have discussed about the problems on De Moivre's theorem. So today also we will continue with the same. So here we have next problem. If x plus 1 by x is equals to 2 cos theta, then show that x raised to n plus 1 by x raised to n equals to 2 cos n theta. Okay, so by given we can prove this solution. Given x plus 1 by x equals to 2 cos theta. Okay, so simply here taking LCM we get x square plus 1 equals to 2 cos theta, or this can be written as x square plus 1 equals to 2x cos theta. Okay, so taking this term to the left side we get x square plus 1 minus 2x cos theta equals to 0, right? So we know that sin square theta plus cos square theta is equals to 1. We replace this 1 by sin square theta plus cos square theta. So that replacing this 1 by x square plus sin square plus cos square theta, we get x square as it is. This minus 2x we keep as it is. So here in the place of 1 we can replace it by sin square theta plus cos square theta equals to 0. Now we can observe this one here. This is a square minus b square plus, a square plus b square minus 2ab form. Therefore it can be written as x minus, so in the place of b we have cos theta whole square, okay, equals to, now plus sin square theta can be taken to the right hand side, that is we get minus sin square theta. Now squaring on both side, taking square root on both side, we get, so here square root get cancels. We get x minus cos theta equals to minus root of minus sin square theta. Since here minus sign is there, it can be written as root of minus sin square theta. Okay. So now this can be written as, you know that wherever we have the root of negative term, this can be represented by I term. So that is, so this root of minus sin square theta can be written as root of minus 1, or in the root only you can write minus 1 into sin square theta. So which is equals to x minus cos theta equals to, so this can be written as minus root of minus 1 value is I. So root, square root and square get cancels. Therefore we get plus or minus I sin theta. Okay. Because of, we know that root of minus 1 is equals to I. Okay. So that means here x minus cos theta value is equals to plus or minus sin theta, I sin theta. So now taking this cos to cos theta to the right hand side, we get x value which is equals to, on taking this to the right side it becomes plus. So it can be written as cos theta plus or minus I sin theta. Okay, so already we know that if x is in the a plus ib form, then its conjugate, it is x bar. Conjugate means it's x bar. So here we get conjugate means if it is plus, we get cos theta. So minus I sin theta. Okay. Suppose if it is minus, we get plus. So that if x is cos theta plus I sin theta, then एक्स बार इज कॉस थीटा माइनस और प्लस आई साइन थीटा. ओके सो एक्स बार, सो माइनस इफ इट इज माइनस मीन्स इट कैन बी रिटन एज 1 डिवाइडेड बाई एक्स. सो सपोज आई कंसिडर रेसिप्रोकल ऑफ दिस वन 1 बाई एक्स, देन इट बिकम्स सो 1 डिवाइडेड बाई दिस टर्म कॉस थीटा प्लस और माइनस आई साइन थीटा. सो इट गोज टू द न्यूमरेटर, इट बिकम्स कॉस थीटा प्लस और माइनस बिकम्स माइनस और प्लस आई साइन थीटा. ओके सो दैट 1 बाई एक्स वैल्यू इज इक्वल्स टू कॉस थीटा माइनस और प्लस आई साइन थीटा. ओके ऑल्सो सिंस एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू कॉस थीटा प्लस और माइनस आई साइन थीटा, सो देन एक्स रेस टू एन बाय अप्लाइंग ड्यूमेरिस थ्योरम एक्स रेस टू एन कैन बी रिटन एज कॉस थीटा कॉस बाय अप्लाइंग ड्यूमेरिस थ्योरम कॉस एन थीटा प्लस और माइनस आई साइन एन थीटा. ओके सो सिमिलरली 1 बाय एक्स रेस टू एन कैन बी रिटन एज कॉस थीटा माइनस और प्लस आई साइन थीटा पावर एन इक्वल्स टू कॉस थीटा कॉस एन थीटा माइनस और प्लस आई साइन एन थीटा, राइट. सो दिस इज एक्स रेस टू एन 1 बाय एक्स रेस टू एन. सो नाउ इफ आई ऐड दीज टू then we get consider x raised to n plus 1 by x raised to n. okay so now we have plus or minus, so first now I will consider plus term. okay so or you can write directly both. so x raised to n plus 1 by x raised to n can be written as x raised to n value is this one cos n theta प्लस और माइनस आई साइन एन थीटा प्लस 1 बाय एक्स रेस टू एन प्लस 1 बाय एक्स रेस टू एन इज दिस वन कॉस एन थीटा माइनस और प्लस आई साइन एन थीटा. ओके सो यू कैन ऑब्जर्व दैट कॉस एन थीटा इज देयर बट हियर वी हैव प्लस और माइनस आई साइन थीटा. सो वेर एवर वी हैव प्लस हियर वी गेट सॉरी इट इज माइनस और प्लस. ओके सो इफ इट इज प्लस देन वी गेट माइनस साइन, इफ इट इज माइनस वी गेट प्लस साइन, वॉट एवर वी हैव दिस टर्म. सो अपोजिट ऑफ दिस वन दैट इज कॉन्जुगेट ऑफ दिस वन. ओके सो दैट दिस प्लस और माइनस आई साइन थीटा आई प्लस आई और सॉरी माइनस और प्लस आई साइन थीटा गेट कैंसल्स. सो एडिंग दिस टू वी गेट टू कॉस एन थीटा. So this is the proof, that is cos x raised to n divided by, plus 1 divided by x raised to n value is equals to, you remember always it is 2 cos n theta. Okay. So from the above we can have one note that if so x raised to n is cos n theta plus or minus I sin n theta. And 1 by x raised to n is equals to cos n theta minus plus or minus I sin n theta, then x raised to n minus 1 divided by x raised to n can be written as cos n theta plus or minus I sin n theta. Okay, here we have a negative sign cos n theta minus or plus I sin n theta. So here in this case cos cos term get cancels, so here plus or minus, so multiplying with this minus sign this one also becomes, sorry it is minus or plus, multiplying this term minus into minus it becomes, so see here plus or minus I sin theta, multiplying this with minus sign minus minus we get plus, minus into plus we get minus I sin theta. Therefore these two can be added. On adding these two we get plus or minus 2i sin n theta. So always it is x raised to n minus 1 by x raised to n is plus or minus 2i sin n theta. Okay. Next problem. If x plus 1 by x equals to 2 cos theta, then show that x raised to 2n minus 2 into x raised to n cos n theta plus 1 equals to 0. So here also we have almost same steps, because given term is same to the last problem. Okay, by using this we can prove this one. So let's solution given x plus 1 by x 2 cos theta. Okay, so simplifying this one, that is taking LCM, here we get x square plus 1 divided by x equals to 2 cos theta. X square plus 1 2x cos theta, or further simplifying, that is bringing this 2x cos theta to the LHS side, it becomes minus 2x cos theta, okay, plus 1. This 1 can be replaced by cos square theta plus I sin square theta, sorry, not, it is not I, cos square theta plus sin square theta equals to, so here we get 0. Since cos square theta plus sin square theta equals to 1, okay. Next, here these terms, these three terms form the x minus cos theta whole square formula, plus this sign can be taken to the right hand side, it becomes minus sin square theta, right. Next, taking square root on both sides, it becomes, here square and square root get cancels, x minus cos theta equals to, because of negative sign it becomes root of, it can be written as root of minus 1 into sin square theta. So root of minus 1 is equals to I. Now sin square, square and square root get cancelled, removing this we get plus or minus sin theta. Here it becomes x minus cos theta. Since root of minus 1 is equals to I, okay. So x value is equals to cos theta plus or minus I sin theta. So that 1 by x, taking reciprocal, it becomes 1 divided by cos theta plus or minus I sin theta. Okay, taking this to the numerator, power becomes minus 1. Okay, if I take this to the numerator, it becomes cos theta plus or minus I sin theta, power becomes minus 1. So that 1 by x value equals to, by applying De Moivre's theorem, it can be written as cos theta plus into minus becomes minus, minus into plus becomes plus I sin theta. Okay, so this is the x, 1 by x value. Okay, so we have x raised to n is x raised to n. So applying De Moivre's theorem, we can write it as cos theta plus or minus I sin theta power n. So therefore x raised to n value is equals to cos n theta plus or minus I sin n theta. So similarly x raised to n, so if I take reciprocal, that is 1 by x raised to n is equals to cos n theta minus or plus I sin n theta. Okay, now so considering x raised to n plus 1 by x raised to n, okay, already we have done this type. So x raised to n plus 1 by x raised to n is cos n theta plus or minus I sin n theta plus this term, that is cos n theta minus or plus I sin n theta. So cos n theta is equals to 2 cos n theta. This plus or minus, or minus or plus I sin n theta get cancels. So we got x raised to n, 1 by x raised to n is equals to 2 cos n theta. Okay, so here we multiply both sides. So we are multiplying both side by x raised to, multiplying both side by x raised to n, we get x raised to n into x raised to n. One divide here x raised to n into वन बाय एक्स रेस टू एन इक्वल्स टू एक्स रेस टू एन इंटू टू कॉस एन थीटा. सो एडिंग पवर्स वी गेट एक्स रेस टू टू एन दिस एक्स रेस टू एन एक्स रेस टू एन गेट कैंसल्स प्लस वन इट बिकम्स टू एक्स रेस टू एन कॉस एन थीटा. सो टेकिंग दिस टू द एल एच एस साइड बिकम्स एक्स रेस टू टू एन माइनस टू एक्स रेस टू एन कॉस एन थीटा प्लस वन इक्वल्स टू जीरो. दिस इज द रिक्वायर्ड.
नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम, इफ एक्स प्लस वन बाय एक्स इक्वल्स टू टू कॉस अल्फा एंड वाई प्लस वन बाय वाई इज इक्वल्स टू टू कॉस बीटा देन प्रूव दैट फर्स्ट वन एक्स रेस टू एम इंटू वाई रेस टू एन इज इक्वल्स टू कॉस एम अल्फा प्लस एन बीटा प्लस आई साइन एम अल्फा प्लस एन बीटा एंड सेकेंड वन इज वन डिवाइडेड बाय एक्स रेस टू एम इंटू वाई रेस टू एन इज इक्वल्स टू कॉस एम अल्फा प्लस एन बीटा माइनस आई साइन एम अल्फा प्लस एन बीटा एंड द थर्ड वन इज एक्स रेस टू एम इंटू वाई रेस टू एन प्लस वन डिवाइडेड बाय एक्स रेस टू एम इंटू वाई रेस टू एन इक्वल्स टू टू कॉस एम अल्फा प्लस एन बीटा. ओके, सो बाय यूजिंग गिवन वी कैन प्रूव ऑल दीज थ्री. सो लेट्स प्रूव वन बाय वन. सो फर्स्ट वी स्टार्ट विद द गिवन. सो गिवन x plus 1 by x equals to 2 cos alpha. Okay, so here first we solve for x, that means we find out the value of x. So simplifying this one, that means taking LCM and sending to the LHS side we get. So this becomes x square plus 1 equals to, so here it becomes 2x cos alpha, or this can be written as x square minus 2x cos alpha plus 1 equals to 0. Okay. So as we have done in the last problem, so here we replace this 1 by cos square alpha plus sin square alpha. Okay. So that is x square 2x cos alpha as it is. In the place of 1 we write cos square alpha plus sin square alpha equals to 0. So this implies that, so this is a plus a minus b whole square form. So that is x plus cos alpha whole square equals to, we get minus sin square alpha, or this can be written as x plus cos alpha equals to, sending the square to this side you will get square root of minus sin square alpha, or this can be written as square root of minus 1 into sin square alpha. Okay, which is equals to x plus cos alpha equals to root of minus 1 means it is I. So we get I sin alpha. Okay. So here we get plus or minus I sin alpha, since root of minus 1 equals to I. Okay. So that means we got x equals to cos alpha plus or minus. Sorry, here we have minus sign, because here minus is there, minus. Okay, on sending this side it becomes x, cos alpha plus or minus I sin alpha. Okay, so or we may consider only positive sign. So that is x value is cos alpha plus I sin alpha, and one more value, x value is equals to cos alpha minus I sin alpha. Okay, so we got two values. So when x is equals to cos alpha plus I sin alpha, then 1 by x will be cos alpha minus I sin alpha. Okay, so if we have x is equals to minus, then 1 by x will be cos alpha plus I sin alpha. Okay, so for our convenient we consider these values. Okay, so we got x value is equals to cos alpha plus I sin alpha. Then 1 by x value will be cos alpha minus I sin alpha. So similarly, if we solve y, that is by using y plus 1 by y is equals to cos alpha 2 cos beta, there we get, so similarly y value will be same as this one, so only angle will be changed, that is cos beta plus I sin beta, and 1 by y value is equals to cos beta minus I sin beta. Okay, now by using de Moivre's theorem, if I consider x power m, because in the proof we need x power m into y power n, so x power m will be cos alpha plus I sin alpha power m, which is equals to x power m equals to cos m alpha plus I sin m alpha, right? This is x power m value. Similarly, by using de Moivre's theorem, y power n will be, so taking power of this one, cos beta plus I sin beta power n, then y power n becomes cos n alpha, sorry, n beta plus I sin n beta. So right, so these are x power m and y power n values. Now for first one, we consider x power m, y power n values, okay, or we consider LHS. So this is equals to, so here we'll write x power m, y power n value will be cos m alpha plus I sin m alpha into y power n value is cos n beta plus I sin n beta. Okay, so this is equals to, multiplying these two terms we get cos m alpha cos n beta plus I cos m alpha sin n beta plus I sin m alpha into cos n beta plus I into I square sin m alpha into sin n beta. Okay, we know that this I square value is minus 1, therefore on grouping these two terms one side we get cos m alpha cos n beta minus sin m alpha sin n beta. Here in these two terms we can take I as a common term, plus I cos m alpha sin n beta plus sin m alpha cos n beta. Now so this is cos of a plus b form. Okay, cos of a plus b, cos a cos b minus sin a sin b, so this becomes cos of a plus b formula. So therefore it is cos of m alpha plus n beta, so plus I. Now this is sin of a plus b formula form, therefore here we replace this by sin of m alpha plus n beta. So this is the first proof. Okay, consider this as equation 1. Now for second one, we consider reciprocal of the first one. Taking reciprocal of equation 1, we get 1 by x raised to m into y raised to n equals to 1 divided by cos m alpha plus n beta plus I sin m alpha plus n beta. Taking this term to the numerator, it becomes cos m alpha plus n beta plus I sin m alpha plus n beta whole power become minus 1. Okay, we are taking this term to the numerator. Now applying de Moivre's theorem, here this sign becomes minus. Okay, that is 1 divided by x raised to m into y raised to n becomes, so multiplying, that is applying de Moivre's theorem, it becomes cos m alpha plus n beta minus I sin m alpha plus n beta. Okay, this is the second proof. Okay, consider this as equation 2. Now for third one, we consider LHS of the third one is x raised to m into y raised to n plus 1 divided by x raised to m y raised to n. From equation 192, we can substitute x raised to m into y raised to n value and 1 divided by x raised to m into y raised to n. So its value is, by the equation 1, is cos m alpha plus n beta plus I sin m alpha plus n beta plus, by the equation 2 we have its value, so that is plus cos m alpha plus n beta minus I sin m alpha plus n beta. So this minus sign minus term plus and minus I sin m alpha plus n beta get cancels. So adding these two we get 2 cos m alpha plus n beta. So here, so this is the RHS, that is we have proved x raised to m into y raised to n plus 1 divided by x raised to m y raised to n equals to 2 cos m alpha plus n beta. So this is the required proof.